and instead stepped into faith, moving forward into 2022. Imagine the new doors that will open for you when you choose to go first and actually open that door for yourself.
Welcome to Warrioress Podcast. I am Kristy Renae Obst, leading medicine woman and mentor for fierce feminine leaders. And ladies, that is why you are here, because you are fierce, you are feminine, and you are a leader. You have the capacity to lead your life, to stand strong in the power and in the vulnerability of who you are, to reclaim the complete woman, the complete package, to not shut down your heart, shield up your heart and hide, to be able to unapologetically stand up in your power and be you in the world, doing what you want to do and leading your life how you want to lead it. On this podcast, we have real talks from real women. It's not all just sunshine and rainbows. We get into what it takes to activate and embody the fierce feminine leader that you are and own all of your womanly power. So get ready to be educated, inspired, motivated, open, and activated on your journey to unlocking your fierce feminine nature. Okay, warrioress, it's time to shine.
Well, we are nearly at the end of the year, and what a massive year it has been. I hope you have given yourself some time or are able to give yourselves some time still to sit and reflect on the year that's been and give yourself some space to really start to create the year that is about to become. I wanted to speak today on change. Change is a thing that we are so scared of, mostly. We're scared of the unknown. We're scared of things looking different to how they are. We get caught up in our comfort zones, which if you've been listening to me for a while or done any of my programs, then you'll know I often call it the uncomfortable comfort zone, because yeah, we're comfortable there, but most of the time it's not really that comfortable. It's not really what our soul is wanting and thriving in, you know. It's just that. It's comfortable, it's safe, and it's known. And getting caught up in the comfortable, in the safe, and in the known doesn't allow us to thrive, to live in this state of possibility, in that anything can happen, that we are catalysts for change, that we have the potential to achieve everything and anything that we want to achieve and that we want to put our mind to. And so ask yourself right now, is that comfort zone that you're in really all that comfortable? And what is it about change that really scares you? Because I found if we can come face to face with the things that we fear, with the change, with the unknown, sometimes with the hard stuff, or what we perceive as hard, then we are already actually making leaps and bounds into what it is that we want to create for ourselves in our lives. So what is it that you fear about change, about the unknown? We seem to spend so much time not allowing change to happen. We are perpetual control freaks and we like to control everything in our lives. And the one only thing that we can actually guarantee, actually, is that things are going to change. And when we're so busy holding on to how things are, holding on to the past, how things were, we don't allow ourselves the magic of what the transformation process of change is. We don't allow for new growth. We don't allow ourselves to close those old doors to actually open new ones. I'm sure if you look deep in your heart, there's many doors that are wanting to be opened. What if we could get comfortable enough with closing those old doors, with resting a little in the unknown, in not knowing what's going to happen, but finding faith in that space to allow something new to come forth? I think a lot of the time we've been taught and we think that we need to have everything all figured out, all planned out. This is the way it's going to go. I know exactly if this happens, then I will do that. And if that happens, then I will do this. And that's just not how life works. And so when we're so, so planned out without any wiggle room to be flexible enough to listen to what we're being asked to do for new and exciting ways to come forth through us, then we're shutting ourselves down and boxing ourselves in to what already was, to living in the past perpetually with what's already been done. Can we be brave enough, courageous enough to rest in the unknown, to rest in the face of change, to actually be different, to be something that we've never been before, to actually become who we are meant to be? Not even who we are meant to be, more of who we are. The parts of us that we've just forgotten about, that we've put up on the shelf and forgotten how to dream and how to courageously go forth for what it is that we want. And so facing this fear of change, getting comfortable with things are changing. I mean, would you just look at the world the last couple of years and the amount of change that has happened? And whether we like it or not, it's happening. And so there is a divine amount of acceptance that needs to come into this. Like, I might not like this, but things are changing. And I can put my perception out in the world that it's bad, but do I really know? Do I really know the grand plan of what this change is bringing? No, I don't. I don't have a crystal ball. I can't see into the future. I can't control the change. What I can control is who I am being, how I am perceiving this situation, the choices that I wish to make in my life, the things that I want. The only thing that you are in control of, really, in these times of change is your perception, your choices, who you are being. And it's in who you are being, actually, that makes the biggest impact in what is happening in the world, in what is happening in your life. And so can you start to get comfortable with the changes that are taking place? And even maybe start to enjoy them. I heard this really beautiful saying a few weeks back, and that was, fear and faith are asking the same thing of you. They're asking you to trust in something you can't see, trust in the unknown. And I heard that and I thought, wow, that is everything. Fear and faith are asking the same thing of you, to trust in something that you can't see. Can you really see fear? And can you really see faith? No. So, what is it that you are giving your energy to fear, to the what ifs? What's going to happen if this happens? Oh my God, change. I'm too scared to make change because I'm stuck in my comfort zone and this feels safe and known to me, even though I don't really like it. And I'm so scared of what's going to happen when I step out of that, which is okay, right? It's normal. It's biologically how we're wired to survive. So we need to give ourselves a little bit of a break, but that's how we react to life. But what if we could start responding with faith? What if we could start aligning ourselves to faith? To step out of our uncomfortable comfort zones and into the unknown with full faith, full knowing that we are cared for, that we are supported, that we are being led to something greater than we even know, than we can even conceptualize in our lives. That's going to lead us to everything that we've ever wanted and needed. This is the opportunity that happens when you start to accept that change is a part of life. It is normal. And the more we can rest in that uncomfortable state of change, the easier it gets to sit in the unknown. The more faith we can actually build, we can choose faith, build faith, and then every moment when we're in the unknown, we don't ever have to fall back into our uncomfortable comfort zones. No. We have a deeper knowing inside ourselves that we can step forward into the new with a sense of peace and ease. That is, and not living in the stress cycle that fear creates. So what if you took that forward into 2022? What if you chose now that you were going to align to faith instead of fear? What if you looked at your life so far, at the past year, completed it, closed all those old doors and left fear behind that door and instead stepped into faith, moving forward into 2022. Imagine the new doors that will open for you when you choose to go first and actually open that door for yourself. When you can say, I don't really know where this is leading me, but I know that I have to go. And when I follow my own intuition, my own heart, when I have enough courage inside of myself to do that, it always leads to more good things to me. Why? Because I'm not doing it out of fear, but I'm doing it out of faith. This is the magic of working within yourself like this, with working with your spiritual self and gaining mastery over the deep inner workings of your life. Imagine having that level of self-trust that anything you stepped into had that vibration of faith in it. That brings back, magnetizes back things of the same resonance, of the same goodness to you tenfold. And so that's my wish for you, finishing off 2021 and stepping into 2022. This is stepping in with faith. And if you're struggling with this, if you need more support with this, then make sure you reach out to me. This is what I guide women through and to discovering this inside of yourself. And so I want to say a big thank you for being with me over the last year with warrioress. This is something, starting a podcast, I never ever thought I would do. I was always too scared and worried about what have I got to say, who's going to listen to me, all of that jazz. So I want to thank you so much for listening, for being a part of this ride with me. And with the subject of change, I want to let you know that warrioress is evolving to something new and exciting next year. I have lots of things changing and in the works next year. And so keep an eye out on my social media to see all of the brand new things that are happening, how everything is evolving. And next time you tune in to this podcast, there's going to be a new name, there's going to be a new feel, and it's going to be exciting. This is change. This is the evolution process. And if we're too scared to let go of the past, let go of what was, then we are never able to evolve into something greater than what we are. So again, thank you so much for being with me. Reach out to me on Instagram, find me on Facebook, head to the show notes below to get in contact. I wish you a very fearless and faithful end of 2021 and start of 2022. Bless you.